for a while you are on your own. You are alone. If you're the last one, or four kids, you're surrounded by a group. A group of kids. So when you are born, there is already a group of kids around you. Gender and age gap also play a part. So if the age gap, you said in your family is 2 years, 2 years, 2 years, 2 years. If the age gap is very big,
yeah.
Or if the age gap is very small,
yeah.
9 months, 9 months, 9 months, yeah. 9 months, yeah. It will make a big difference to the family. Yeah. I think someone in my family, my great grandmother, her father had a wife and maybe seven children. Then the wife died. Found a new wife and he had another seven children.
14?
Yeah, seven from one mother, seven from the other. And with a big difference in. And they had a confusing family. And I think the first wife was very refined, a lady. Very, very correct, very... And the second wife was like a farming woman, you know, very physical work, very strong, so very different personality of the mothers. So the children were very different, completely different. The refined family, the, you know, good boys, good girls, and then the farming woman. Yeah, they wanted to ride horses and fight. Someone, in fact, I have an interesting family, and people keep making websites about members of my family because some of them are very unusual. This was an uncle of mine. He was about 100 years old. He was from a family, and instead of a belt, he had a piece of string to hold his trousers up. I think he was very rich, really. Very old clothes. He lived like a very poor man, but I think he was very rich, really. Yeah. No, he died about 10 years ago. He was, I think, 105. And instead of a belt, he had a piece of string around his waist so that he didn't spend money on a belt. And he was a car park attendant. If the cars tried to get away without paying, it would pick up rocks and throw stones at the cars. So, a bit strange. Yeah, a bit strange. But he was a good man, and they remember him, so they made a website about him, because they all remember him. Very interesting man. So, we are all influenced by many things. the only child. None of you is an only child. What does it mean when you are the only child? Just one. No sisters, no brothers.
No compare.
That's right. They can't compare you to anyone. They can't compare you to anyone.
And you say this
They call this person the lone wolf. Yeah. The lone wolf who hunts alone in the forest. Yeah. No group. No, you know, does everything. Very independent. Mysterious. If you're an only child, you grow up surrounded by adults. Everyone you know is an adult for the first 3, 4, 5 years of your life. The most important people in your world are adults. Uncles, neighbors, parents, friends of parents. Therefore, the only child is often more mature and more verbal. Yeah. They learn language, they learn to speak, not from the brothers and the sisters, they learn to speak from adults. They learn to speak like adults. This allows gains in intelligence that exceed other bird or birth